this old world has many pleasures. You can seek them day by day. It may offer fame and fortune, but this one truth still remains. You cannot find full contentment in your heart down deep within, till you seek to be forgiven and your pardon from your sin. We are more than satisfied with Jesus every day, how we love to sing of Him and lift our voice in praise. Since we met our blessed Savior, we no longer live in vain. For He's given life real meaning, oh praise His holy name.
Since we found true satisfaction in the things worth living for, we no longer seekers' pleasures, now we're seekers of the Lord. To be more and more like Jesus is our earnest, sincere cry. We are more than satisfied in His love we now abide. We are more than satisfied with Jesus every day. How we love to sing of Him and lift our voice in praise. Since we met our blessed Savior, we no longer live in pain. For He's given life real meaning, oh praise His holy name. Every day, how we love to sing of Him and lift our voice in praise. Since we met our blessed Savior, we no longer live in vain. For He's given life real meaning, oh praise His holy name.
Since we found true satisfaction in the things worth living for, we no longer seekers' pleasures, now we're seekers of the Lord. To be more and more like Jesus is our earnest, sincere cry. We are more than satisfied in His love we now abide. We are more than satisfied with Jesus every day. How we love to sing of Him and lift our voice in praise. Since we met our blessed Savior, we no longer live in vain. For He's given life real meaning, oh praise His holy name.
We are more than satisfied. I believe you are too. If you're a Christian tonight, you just know that He satisfies every longing of your soul. We thank God for the privilege of being here. Had a wonderful service this morning down at Beach Grove Church of the Independent Church of the Nazarene, and it's a privilege to be right here. We've sung here a few times. I've directed here a few times, and it's always a joy to try to lead in songs that tell of our wonderful Savior and how good He is. Verse that's been on my mind throughout the day. In fact, I read it this morning again in the Psalms there. Psalm 71:8 says, if I can get it right, Let my mouth be filled with praise and with thy honor all the day long. And that's exactly how I feel about it tonight. I want to be one that's full of praise for our wonderful God. And we live in a time, we know there's just so much going on in our world, so much distress in some areas. People not satisfied, of course, no matter what president we put in, that type of a thing. But aren't you glad, as that song said, we can be more than satisfied? And I just think there's enough happens in all of our lives to help us to realize that in God alone, is our true satisfaction and contentment. And we just praise God. Thank God for these wonderful young people that are surrounding you tonight. And I know they want to be a blessing to your heart. So we praise God for his help.
just want to thank the Lord. I was standing out there in the hallway back there before service, and Josh Heyer, my good friend, came back and got me and asked me if I'd slip into the prayer room with him. And I went in there, and I didn't know it, but I needed to go in there. And I asked God if he would search my heart, and he did. And I thank you, and I think about that song, we're so satisfied. I'm satisfied tonight in Jesus. And I'm just thankful that he knows what we need, even when we don't know. He knows what we need. And I'm thankful for his gifts.
I'm thankful that in him I find life's real meaning. You know, I even just a couple years back, even though being saved, I felt so lost sometimes. And I've been reading Psalms 40 here recently, and it says, you know, that God hears your cry, and he inclines to your prayers, and he'll lift you up from the miry, you know, the miry clay, and out of the horrible pit. He'll establish your goings, but not only that, he'll put a new song in your heart. And I love that phrase in He Has Done Great Things, the Majesty Medley, where he says, his anthem's raised because of all the things that he's done. You know, when you sing the national anthem, you put your hand on your heart. But whenever I think of Jesus, you know, I know that his hand's over my heart. And I want to give him everything. I love him so much. I'm so thankful because he has done so many great things in my life. And I just want to praise him for that today.
Oh, God for all these sins. So throughout a good part of my life, I've struggled with the idea that I'm just an anomaly, just another face in the crowd, and that I'm just nothing to, that I'm just another number, another person, another face. And then the other, God just reminded me earlier in Matthew chapter 5, where it talks about God loving the sparrows. And he watched the one who watched all of the sparrows and nurtured them for life. And the God who walks among the grass, and he can count every single blade of grass, he knows all of them, and the intricate design behind all of them. And he knows every single flower, every single field, across every single place in the universe. Oh, thank God that I'm not just an anomaly, that I'm just on another face. That he loves me far more than a single blade of grass or a flower or a sparrow that he's nurtured. I want to thank God that I'm within the gaze of his all-seeing eye, and he loves me so far, far more than I could ever imagine.
In that surround song we sang, it was talking about how we love to sing of him and lift our voice in praise. And I'm not the greatest singer. I'm not the greatest singer at all, by no means. But I'm just so thankful that he gave us the ability to sing. He gave us the ability to praise him through song. And I love to sing and just sing about him. And it's just so encouraging to sing songs that talk about him and that lift him up. I'm just so thankful that he gives us blessings that we don't deserve, that we don't deserve by any stretch of the imagination, but he gives them to us freely and just willfully. And I'm so thankful for the many blessings he gives us and the things he allows us to do.
Amen. Well, I don't know about you, but I just love that song. It's so super. God can do. God's done so many great things for each of us. And let's believe him for more and more. You know, there are some things probably in each of our lives that we just maybe looks absolutely impossible. In our human, it is, but we serve a big God. I love the verse there in Chronicles that says, "For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth, showing himself strong in behalf of them whose heart is perfect toward him." I'm more and more convinced that's the key, to have a perfect heart toward him. We can't be perfect. We have at least I can't in every way, and everybody's eyes, we have our faults. I'm sure I have plenty. But I'm glad that we can have an absolutely perfect heart toward God. We desire to serve him, be surrendered to him. I more and more want to live that way and see what great things God can do. And we've just been so blessed. We've been brought up knowing the Word of God, reading the Word of God, and seeing the great things he did back then. And like I said, he's done many great things right here in this church. We just praise him. Thank you to all of you come, visitors, and all that are here. We'd like to sing a song now. It says, "I'm standing on the solid rock." It's good to have a good foundation. Amen? Amen. A little different style here, but hope you still can enjoy it.
times I strayed away from Jesus, like a lamb that leaves the flock without a care. And the time soon came when I'd gone too far and stumbled. And the more I try, the more I lose my way. Lamb that the shepherd left the flock for, I was out in the cold. Found me, he put his arms all around me, and I'll never be alone anymore. Now I've tried to climb the mountains of this life and failed. I was thinking of myself in my own game. Oh, but the shepherd came and he found me on the cliffs of sin. And from that moment, life has never been the same. I'm the lamb that the shepherd left the flock for. I was out in the cold. All alone. So indeed, when Jesus found me, he put his arms all around me, and I'll never be alone anymore. Now I'm back where I belong, and I'm so happy. I can hear my shepherd's voice all the time, and I'll follow in the path where he may lead me. For this shepherd Jesus is a friend of mine. I'm the shepherd left the flock for. I was out in the cold all alone. So in me, when Jesus found me, he put his arms all around me, and I'll never be alone. Shepherd's voice all the time, and I'll follow in the path where he may lead me. For this shepherd Jesus is a friend of mine. I'm the lamb that the shepherd out in the cold and all alone. So indeed, when Jesus found me, he put his arms all around me, and I'll never be alone anymore. And I'll never be alone. Oh,
could we withink the ocean fill, and were the skies of parchment made, were every star on earth a quill, and every man a scribe by trade, from sky to sky. How rich and pure, how measureless and strong, it shall forevermore endure, the saints and
I'm so unworthy for everything he's done in my life, from where he, even though I grew up in the past, so many things I've done, I didn't deserve to even grow up, the things he's done for me, and I'm just so thankful for everything, and I just want to follow his will in my life.
I want to praise God. Just sitting here singing that song, I was thinking, God could have destroyed the whole earth, but he decided not to. He loved us so much that he came to die for us instead of just destroying us, and I want to thank God that he wanted to do that for us, and that we can be a part of his love, and that is just amazing to think about, and I praise him for it.
As we were singing, it is no secret what God can do. This morning, this phrase that really stood out to me was, there is no power that can conquer you, for God is on the throne. And this past week was really difficult, especially at the beginning. I felt like the devil was just fighting me and hounding me like crazy. But I was determined, I'm going to go through whatever the cost, no matter what's going to happen, I'm going to go through with him no matter what.
Just think about that love. It's a jealous love. It's wonderful. And I think back, and I was not seeking God. I was not a person in the church. I was out. I was addicted to drugs and alcohol. And God sought me when I didn't deserve it. It was so wonderful. He drew me in, and I'm just so thankful for His love.
Praise God.
See my Jesus on the cross, the people crying. Love.
Amen. I'm so thankful for that reality tonight. When he cried, "It is finished," the veil in the temple that separated us from the Holy of Holies, that protected the Holy of Holies. When he cried, "It is finished," the veil in that temple was rent in two from top to bottom, forever signifying that man now has access to God, that man can now approach boldly the throne of grace and receive grace and help in our time of need. It forever signified that man that was alienated and cut off from God can now have a relationship, can now be reconciled back to God. I say praise the Lord this evening. He can do that for you. He can do that for me. Praise his name, because he cried, "It is finished." Because he paid the price and he made the way for each and every one of us to be brought back into a right relationship with God. I say praise the Lord. Well, I know you want to hear the choir, and they'll be coming back in just a few short minutes. But I do want to talk a little bit about Union Bible College, about what God is doing, and give a little bit of an update of how he's just working and moving there on our campus. There's three questions that may come to mind when talking about a Bible college or talking about Union Bible College. And the first question, I really probably don't have to labor on that too much. You've been a supporting church over the years, and I just want to stop and say we deeply appreciate everything that this church has done for the college and for individuals here, even personally. We just want to say thank you very much for all that you've done for UBC. I don't feel like I have to labor much on the first point, because you know us. You're in our backyard, and some of you have even served the staff and faculty over the years. But the first question is what? What is UBC? As you know, we're an institution of higher education that's committed to the propagation of scriptural holiness. We still believe in scriptural holiness, amen? Committed to the propagation of scriptural holiness and the preparation of servant leaders. I'm thankful that I can report to you that there's some evidence of effectiveness in that. That's an important aspect when thinking about your mission and purpose. Is it happening? Has it been happening? A statistic I was given, not taking any credit or praise to ourselves, we're giving it to God, but a statistic that I was given told me since 1970, 70% of those that have graduated and moved on from Union Bible College are in ministry today in their area of study. I say to God be the glory. Second question is how? How do we fulfill that mission? How do we fulfill that purpose? How do we do what we do? And obviously, as you know, through classroom setting, through chapel there on campus, this church was involved in the local IHC. That would be a part of that as well. There, the different events that happen on campus. There's many ways that we can answer that are obvious. But I'm thankful I can inform you tonight that we're doing it. And we're answering the how question in greater ways than we've ever done before. As you, maybe some of you know, just the past last semester and then also this semester, we've begun the process of launching online classes. And we do currently have some online classes already being offered and planning to advance that. We also offer live stream classes for people to watch a class anywhere they're at, from all over the country, all over the world. They can watch a class as it's happening, live stream. God's helping us to do this, to fulfill our mission and purpose in greater ways than we've ever done before. We're also doing it. How are we doing to answer that question? Through increased financial stability. I'm thankful I can report to you that God has been meeting the needs. He's been blessing and helping. And it's because people like you and churches like this that have stood behind us over the years. I'm thankful that I can report the last three fiscal years have been record years. And in fact, this past fiscal year, the highest amount of income ever to be reported to come into the college was this past fiscal year. I say to God be the glory. He's meeting the needs and he's blessing and helping. And with that, over the past 4 years, we've been able to retire somewhere around $700,000 worth of debt. And I can currently stand up here and report to you that we have no short-term debt. I say praise the Lord for that. He's helping us to be financially responsible. Also, through increased enrollment. Through an increased enrollment over the past 4 years, in fact, has been somewhere over 100% increase. And with this past fall, we reached 100 total students, which is the highest we've been since 1987. Are you catching on this evening? God's doing something. He's up to something. His work's advancing at UBC, and we're thankful to be a part of it. Also, through the accreditation process, we are on our way toward initial accreditation. We have candidate status right now through the ABHE, a Christian Accrediting Association. And then lastly, we're answering the how question. We're fulfilling our mission and purpose by our 10-year strategic plan that we just unveiled this past fall. This involves a continued financial stability and growth, and it continues to involve enrollment growth and academic and professional development, and then renovation of existing spaces. I'm sure many of you have been on campus, but if you haven't, I guess we'll be over there here in a little bit. You can see some of the upgrades that have been going on, some of the renovations. And then we're also trusting God for maybe some new things, some things outside of the box, some things that may seem impossible with man, but not impossible with God. We're believing God for some new buildings, new construction projects that will be happening over the next couple years. See, we're moving forward, but it's not because of us, it's because of God. It's because of His help, because of His strength and His touch. And then the last question, and perhaps the most important question, a question that we all must come to terms with and answer. And that is, you know, we've answered what and how. The last question is why? Why? Why do we do what we do? Why do we come here even tonight? Why do we propagate scriptural holiness? Why do we prepare certain leaders? If you're a prospective student, why should you consider attending Union Bible College? And why should the Noblesville Pilgrim Holiness Church continue to stand behind Union Bible College and to support the work there at UBC? And the answer is simple. And that's the fact that God still has a plan. God still wants to do something. God still wants to raise up another generation that's going to pick up the torch, that's going to go out and find those that are lost on the sidelines of life and tell them about the cross and tell them how they can be saved and how they can be found and their lives can be changed. You see, He wants to raise up another generation. As you've seen on the risers, to answer the why question, He wants to raise up a John Mark Forsey. He wants to raise up a Jeffrey Glick. And others that are connected with this church and that have been connected with this church and with the Pilgrim Holiness Church at large and with the Church of Jesus Christ. See, He's raising up another generation of young people that are answering the call. They're saying yes to Him. And they're going to go out and do great things for Him. But they're going to need your prayers. And they're going to need your financial support as we continue to see the work of Union Bible College move forward, as we continue to propagate scriptural holiness, prepare servant leaders who will go out and change the world with the unchanging Word of God. We want to thank you once again for all that you do for this church. If you have any questions or if you want to figure out how you can support, there's information at the booth. Or you can see me after the service. I'd be glad to help you out in that area. We want to remind you of some events coming up on campus. At the end of March, we have our World Changers Week, March 27th through the 31st. We want to invite each and every one of you there. This is a new thing we've done. Our first one was last year. We have another one this year. Rodney Loper will be the speaker. And then also for you young people, prospective students, preview days, April 27th through 29th. We want to invite you out for that. Also, failed to mention bus convention. The first week of March will be happening there on campus. You won't want to miss it. This time, we'll turn this part of the service over to John Mark.
Amen. It's good to hear what God's doing over at the school. I know better than most of you here because I go to that school, but it's good to sit back and to see it from a different perspective. At this time, I'm going to ask the ushers to come forward. You've been sitting, listening. Now it's your time to get involved. And that doesn't mean singing per se. We're going to do our best to give back to the school, to the work that God is doing there, asking the ushers to come forward at this time. And as we pray, if you would keep my dad in your prayers, I won't say anything, just that he has a temperature over 100. So please keep him in your prayers, and we'll pray that God can help him tonight. I'm going to ask if Brother Bobby Pickett, would you stand and pray for the offering, please?
Thank you.
pray and pray for school. That's important. I'm glad God's still calling young people to train. I don't think it's a step down to go to Bible school. Amen? I think it's one of the greatest things in all the world to go and be trained and go out and be. Now, not everybody call. I know every young person is called to do that, 8 to 4 years or whatever. But I think it's a wonderful place to meet a life mate. Wonderful place to just make a lot of friends. I don't regret any of my days going to Bible school and enjoyed it so much. And I've been out of Bible school for a few years as well. I don't regret any of those days. Some of them have been tough, but they have been wonderful. So praise God. Well, I think you'll recognize this song. If you don't, you probably haven't been in the church too long.
Oh,
I believe he's alive and well tonight. Our God lives because he has a future in his hand. We can trust him. We can believe him. Praise God. Well, thank you again for coming. We have one more song we'd like to share. You'll even get out before 7:30, I think. But I like the big songs. I like the songs that just like that, that are big and are praising God and all that. But I also love the songs that are just songs that help us maybe to search our hearts or ask God to search our hearts and just to make sure we're really ready for that time. And I want to be ready every single day. Amen? I have something I want to read here, and then we're going to sing, end with a song. I love the song, I Surrender All, and we'd like to sing at least 2-3 verses of that and go into the chorus, To Be Like Jesus, for our last song tonight. Make sure your heart is right with God. It will be worth it all to live for Jesus every day and heed the Master's call. Don't take a chance with your one soul. You only have one life. So do your best to follow God and live for Jesus Christ. Make sure your heart is right with God. Every sin confessed. This is the only way to heaven, the way to find sweet rest. Forgive the wrongs that have been done against you in the past. Surrender all to our great God. On him, all burdens cast. Make sure your heart is right with God. Pray to be spirit-led. You'll not regret days lived for God as on his word you're fed. Life is so short. Now is the time to know that all is well. Then that blessed hope will brighter shine until in heaven you dwell. It's good to know that we're all surrendered to him, isn't it? It's good to know that all is well, that we're are serving God with all of our hearts. And while we sing this last song, just allow the Lord to speak to your heart. Maybe there are some here that just know it's not well with your heart. And I'm glad this can be a wonderful night in your life. You can turn everything over to God and know that all is surrendered to him. Praise God.
Surrender all to him, I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily. I bow, worldly pleasures all forsaken. Take me, Jesus, take me.